The Thomas Coelho trial resumed on Monday, the 17th of April 2023, with the revelations by the International Crimes Division that security breaches on three separate occasions have contributed to the lengthy trial of the former LRA colonel.
To recall, we have had to retreat from this trial, I think twice or three times, because of security breaches, and it has also contributed to that.
In March 2009, Thomas Coelho was injured during hostilities between the Ugandan army and the LRA rebels in the Democratic Republic of Congo. He was brought into Uganda for medical treatment and subsequently put into custody. Thomas Coelho has been on trial since 2011. He is charged with 93 counts of war crimes and crimes against humanity, including rape, murder, and recruitment of child soldiers.
It's a complicated case with complicated procedures, and it being the first of its kind that we are handling in Uganda, the trial panel is very careful that they have to make a precedent that we can confidently follow, that can be referred to internationally, because it's an international case. So I should say that we are looking forward to finishing this case.
However, this is an unprecedented trial in the history of Uganda, and it has taken longer than expected due to various reasons. At one time, the former Lord Resistance Army colonel requested to be transferred to the International Criminal Court, where his compatriot Dominic Ongwen was being tried.
This, at long last, the prosecution is closing his case, and then it will give us an opportunity to open the defense case. So at this pace, at least we see hope. You've seen for several times the accused has been complaining, wishing that we should take him, or the government should take him to ICC.
Speaking on the corridors of the Gulu High Court, the defense lawyer Caleb Alaka shared that the delay in the court proceedings had had a mental damage on Thomas Coelho.
A trial must not be as long as this. If this was not because of intervening factors like the constitutional petition, the appeal, and COVID, will have said this is the most unconstitutional trial.
In the courtroom, both the prosecution and defense lawyers can be seen whispering to Thomas Coelho. After this moment of consultation, the state prosecutor Charles Kamuli confirms that the trial is now reaching its climax, with 49 witnesses cross-examined so far.
Our strategy as prosecution is to lead about 56 witnesses and a close. In this session, we are going to close our prosecution case and hand it over to the defense to prepare their defense. So it's a good thing to hear that we are coming to the conclusion of the case when we close our prosecution case.
While the registrar of the International Crimes Division of the High Court reinstates that the government has released money in order to fasten the trial process.
And I want to say that this time we have been facilitated, and I think that is why we have moved it towards the end of this case.
Thomas Coelho is said to have been born in Pabo in Amuru district in 1987. He was abducted by the LRA rebels while on his way to school. He later became a colonel in the ranks of the Joseph Kony-led Lord Resistance Army rebels. I am Joseph Omagoro, reporting for the news in Gulu City.